Hello internet, what's going on, and welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions, the place where we set our compass to true north, hitch on our snow cleats, and take up the mammoth trek of an Arctic apocalypse. Today, as per usual, I'll be your host Jack Finch, as we say goodbye to sunshine, cower under the cover of a meteorological meltdown, spark up the furnace and pray to high heaven that we don't lose another finger, and cautiously ask the question, what if another ice age happened? Roll the clip. Yeah, that clip's probably a little bit of an over-exaggeration. Ice ages don't just happen overnight, and they definitely don't just happen over a matter of minutes, but you get the picture. Technically speaking, we're in an ice age right this minute. Before we get into that though, you know the drill by now. If you're a fan of this video, or just LBQ in general, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button, because you know we won't hold it against you. Also, be sure to share this video with your nearest and dearest, perhaps even that special person that you choose to wait out an ice age with. Aww. So what exactly is an ice age anyway, or at least how do they happen? Well, strap on your science helmets, because we're going to find out. In recent history, that is, because you know, the last proper ice age finished like 12,000 years ago. In short, it's a long and complicated process. 500 years ago though, we saw a period of low solar activity, termed the Maunder Minimum, a phrase coined after astronomers Walter and Annie Maunder discovered that the planet's axis was affected by a shortage of sunspots between 1645 and 1715, and thus resulted in a mini ice age. In a full blown ice age though, this process takes thousands of years to even begin. It's triggered when summer temperatures in the northern hemisphere fail to rise above freezing for a number of years, the cause of which is generally up for debate. Milankovitch cycles, tectonic plates, fluctuations in ocean currents that all potentially result in the exact same thing. Meaning, in short, that winter snowfall doesn't melt and starts to build up, compressing over time and glaciating into ice sheets. Over thousands of years, these ice sheets build up, and before you know it, it's starting to feel pretty damn chilly. For the last million years or so, this has been happening roughly every 100,000 years. And guess what? Technically speaking, we're due another cold snap right about now. The difference? Yeah, humanity in general and our damn pesky methane emissions. It's a stark fact that humanity's industrial society has been warming the planet to an unprecedented scale. Since 1998, our climate has accumulated 2.6 billion atomic bombs worth of heat, and it's still getting hotter. Generally speaking, it's considered by many people in the scientific community evidence enough that we may have accidentally thwarted the next ice age, but at what cost? The Arctic permafrost is degrading, the Arctic sea ice is melting, and the Greenland ice sheet is losing its mast at an accelerated rate. It's a song that is less ice and more fire. But let's say we've got it all wrong and we throw science straight out of the window. Let's say an ice age is looming its frozen head just around the corner, and in the next 50 years the planet is a frigid imposter of its former self and things can only get colder. How would we fare? What would the population look like? Without a doubt, it would have some pretty insane consequences for our civilization. Irreversible consequences that would change the course of mankind's future as we know it. Kicking off, it'd be the obvious, a damn sight colder than it is now. Now, all your friends that complain that they're chilly even though it's warm as hell, yeah, they'll probably be dead unless they could acclimatize to some pretty negative temperatures. In all likelihood, we begin to see major changes in the northern hemisphere, particularly areas like Canada and the United States, Greenland, the whole of northern Asia, and most of northern Europe. Huge regions inhabited by millions of people would become completely and utterly uninhabitable, covered in thick ice sheets and a savage, frigid climate. What would that do to the population? Well, quite a bit. If not during the initial stages of a completely different planet, the population of planet Earth would inevitably dwindle to a much smaller, more colder bunch. This place here, near Alisund in Svalbard, the northernmost town in the world. Poof. Gone. Covered in ice like a White Walker version of Vesuvius. Greece Fjord in Nunavut, the northernmost settlement in Canada, poof, gone. At the best of times, these habitats are a grueling, merciless place to live. In an ice age, they'd be relegated to the encroaching ice of an apocalyptic snowdown. For the survivors of an ice age, our infrastructure would be a thing of the past. It would be down to a complete coin toss as to whether we could support our remaining humans. For the most part, a lot less agricultural land would be available, and by a lot less, we mean almost none. It would be very difficult to support the human population population purely on the basis of there being too many mouths to feed and not enough growable crop yield. And as we know from history, a lack of resources generally equals conflict, and then we haven't just got the weather to contend with, but full-blown Arctic warfare. In the last mini ice age, temperatures dropped so low that the River Thames in London froze on at least 7 different occasions. With its major river kaput, London's commerce ground to a halt, and thousands of people in the surrounding cities and countryside died. Farm animals were wiped out completely, and the wind was so cold that it cracked tree trunks. Yeah, we can expect much more of that in this particular scenario. Forget pumpkin spice frappuccinos, Keeping Up with the Kardashians, and KSI versus Logan Paul. Hell, even forget mowing your lawn or enjoying a leisurely canoe ride across the harbour. Even mowing your lawn would become a thing of the past. There'd be two interests that everyone would be tuned into: keeping warm and not starving. Thankfully, we've got thousands of years of human ingenuity on our side, so maybe the last 200,000 years of human evolution have all been a big warm up before the big freeze. Well, what do you guys think? Could you survive another ice age? What do you think would happen to the species as a whole? Let us know your thoughts in the comment box down below. If you've enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and share it on with your nearest and dearest. Also, to stay up to date with our latest and greatest uploads, make sure to hit that subscribe bell floating conveniently below. As always, you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. I've been your host, Jack Finch, and remember, there's no such thing as a stupid question.